Hi guys, want to do a really quick one. Happy Homebrew Friday. It is 5:15 PM here in Finland, so it is beer time. Pint of my Kölsch version number 2. So I have this is my it's hazy. But I think that Kölsch can be hazy. Well, I guess any beer can be hazy. Quick video about what's my plans for the coming weekend in terms of brewing. I spent my lunch hour today fairly well by going to my local homebrew shop and do some shopping over there. So let's look what I managed to get on my credit card. Let's get this big box out of the way for a while still. First of all, this is my 1 gallon jug. I'm going to be making a cider. I have Bulldog cider yeast medium. So interesting to see what kind of final gravity I'm hitting with this. I'm planning to add only the apple juice, no sugar, no nothing like that. So only that. My chuck is dirty. I have also a bunch of puddles which needs cleaning. That's why I bought this double blast puddle washer by Firmtech. Some instructions, and here's the setup. It looks like this. So we have these removable washer heads, and you can even put a bigger one. And my assumption would be that I could rinse, for example, this jug with that one. But let's see. I will install it and let's see if I can show you a quick video at the end how it actually works. And it has a hose delivered as well. But then to the beef. To the actual beef. Here we have a bottle of CO2. This is this kind of a normal SodaStream machine bottle, which you can just refill or exchange to a new bottle in my local grocery store. So easy way of getting food grade CO2. Okie doke. I have also an adapter that fit actually to the top of the bottle, because this bottle is not compatible with the regulator nut. So the regulator is compatible in fact with this one, and this end is compatible with the bottle. So then, that being said, I can attach normal CO2 regulator to the bottle. And this is not now beer related. I like to drink beer, but obviously that's not possible every day, throughout the day at least. And when I'm not drinking beer, I like to drink sparkling water. So that got me thinking that, well, hey, I spent quite a lot of time in this, my brewery shed. So maybe I should have something else to drink here also, other than beer. So plan is to utilize one 5 gallon or 19 liter keg to produce sparkling water, and also have two taps on my geyser. I will put the water to the other tap, and obviously for water, especially when we are talking about sparkling water compared to a beer, the amount of or the volumes of CO2 is quite different. For sparkling water, it can be even double the volume in CO2. That's why I would need a double regulator, so I could regulate the pressure for my beer and the pressure for my water. Instead of getting, because I don't have a regulator with two adjustments, so instead of getting one of those, because my current regulator is not that kind of premium thing, it was quite on the cheap side when I bought it, so I decided that maybe I could upgrade that to a better one and then utilize the cheaper regulator into this thingy and use that to carbonate the water. So I'm planning to put this with my old regulator into the geyser and carbonate the water there and use the other beer faucet to pour that out. So I'm going to clean thoroughly one keg for this purpose, fill it just with my groundwater. The water where I live is excellent. It's groundwater, so it's not from a lake or a river or anything like that. In fact, it's so good, the quality, that the local water company doesn't add anything to the water, no chlorine or nothing. They just run the water through a UV lamp, which will kill the bacteria if it's present there. So no need to add anything. But I like sparkling mineral water, so that it would have kind of a good composition of different kind of minerals and salt as well. For that reason, we have a soda stream in the house. We have been adding a pinch of mineral salt to every soda stream bottle when we carbonate it. So I was thinking that I will just take my narcotic scale and measure that how much is that one pinch of salt and just multiply that with 19. So then I get a proper amount of salt to be added to full the keg filled with water, the full keg. How much do I need to add this to get the same thing that we are having in the house with the soda stream machine? So it says that the ingredients are natrium chloride, 57% kalium chloride, 28% magnesium sulfate, 12%, then some lysine, hydrochloride, blah blah, whatever that is, 2%, and then anti-clumping thing, and that's it. Hope that works. I will report back how that went. So that's that. And to replace my old regulator, I got a new one. Yay! That's box thing. There you go. To my eye, this looks like a quality piece of stuff. Let's have a closer look. I haven't opened. So it's manufactured by Hivi Eus Kirchen. I don't know. How do you pronounce that? Can you pronounce that at all? Okay, it will have two outlets with ball valves. It came equipped with the barbs as well, so that's good, with proper seals, with these kind of seals, I don't need to put Teflon tape or anything like that to it. Very nice dials. Good thing that I can screw this or adjust it without a tool, so that's nice. And it's a really sturdy looking piece. So I'm going to put this to my primary bottle, CO2 bottle, and utilize the old one to the water project. So let's see how that goes. And also, I got some yellow caps, of course, so what do you call that? Other than that, let's see how this would work. Other than that, I have the curls in tap, 5.5 ABV. Then I have also winter warmer, 6.7 ABV. And next, chum, ESB. So I'm going to brew my ESB this weekend. For that reason, I got 5 kilos of Marisotter today as well. So going to do that. And I have Lallemand's ESB yeast reserved also for that project. Other than that, I guess that's about it. As to the end, let's plug this in and see how it works. Hopefully it's not a, well, we'll see. Thank you. Enjoy the weekend. Hope you like the video. If yes, thumbs up. If not, thumbs down. Any comments, please comment down below. If you haven't subscribed, please do it now. It's final moments. Okay, thank you. Let's not be strangers. Bye.